couldn't be more honored that you are here on this truly special day, celebrating the new senators and returning senators. If we could please give them a round of applause, please, and say welcome. The hour 12 o'clock having arrived, pursuant to Article 4, Section 3A of the California Constitution, the Senate is going to come to order. The senators, we're going to ask each and every one of you and our guests in the gallery to be able to take seats. And pursuant to Section 9150 of the Government Code, Erica Contreras, Secretary of the Senate, Katrina Rodriguez, Sergeant-at-Arms, and Matthew Burns, Minute Clerk, are in their respective places. To commence the convening of the 2025-2026 session of the great state of California State Senate, we're going to begin with a musical prelude. If we could please give a warm welcome to the Sacramento Women's Chorus. The Sacramento Women's Chorus is a testament to success here in the great city of Sacramento. They're going to be led today by Artistic Director Rachel Jackson. They have two beautiful songs that they're going to kick us off with. Again, another welcome to the Sacramento Women's Chorus. Director Jackson, we welcome you, and to all the members, thank you for being here on this truly special day. In your own time, the floor is yours. the 2025-2026 ceremony. Can we please give a round of applause to the Sacramento Women's Chorus? That was beautiful. Thank you so much. I don't know about you, but I started getting misty-eyed, so we're grateful. Ladies and gentlemen of the Senate, and to our guests, we're going to respectfully request senators-elect, and all guests beyond the rail and in the gallery, we're going to ask you to please rise. We're going to be led in prayer today by our chaplain, Sister Michelle Gorman, after which we're going to ask each of you to please remain standing for the presentation of the colors by the Cal Fire Color Guard, Local 2881. Sister Michelle, good morning. Welcome.
Good morning, Senator McGuire. And let us remember that we are always in the presence of holy mystery. In 1954, Lillian Smith posed the following questions in her book, The Journey. A century from now, what shall be said of our journey in these times? And who shall the shapers have been? Shall they be the hopeful dreamers who were strong enough to suffer for the dream? Or the fearful pessimists who were convinced that dreaming and hope are for sleepers only, not for those awake to the age? A century from now, shall hope have been strong enough to enable living with unanswerable questions? Or shall the pain that a transitional age necessarily brings have caused a retreat to old answers that no longer acknowledge new questions? Gracious God of creativity and newness, as we begin this session, open our eyes to the immensity of our call to be shapers of our future. Let us be hopeful dreamers, dedicating our strength to make the dreams of our people a reality. Help us to live into the unanswerable questions with courage and trust, acknowledging new questions as potential for the discovery of greater truth and freedom. May we listen attentively and respond generously to the needs of all our people, so that a century from now, all will know that our journey was not in vain. We ask this in your name. Amen.
We're going to respectfully request that each of you please remain standing. California is home to the gold standard of firefighters here in the United States of America. And that includes the Cal Fire Color Guard, Local 2881. Color Guard, please present the colors. Ladies and gentlemen of the Senate, we're now going to be led in the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America by Senator Dave Cortese. Senator Cortese.
Please join me. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Color Guard, please retire the colors.
Color Guard.
Thank you. You all may be seated. Senators, senators-elect, and all guests, we're getting to the good part. The Secretary of the Senate will now read the names of the senators-elect. Mr. Secretary, please proceed.
Megan Daly, 1st District. Christopher Cabaldon, 3rd District. Jerry McNerney, 5th District. Jesse Araguin, 7th District. Timothy S. Grayson, 9th District. Scott D. Wiener, 11th District. Josh Becker, 13th District. David Cortese, 15th District. John Laird, 17th District. Rosalisi Ochoa-Bogue, 19th District. Monique Limon, 21st District. Suzette Martinez Valadares, 23rd District. Sasha Renee Perez, 25th District. Henry I. Stern, 27th District. Eloise Gomez Reyes, 29th District. Sabrina Cervantes, 31st District. Lena A. Gonzalez, 33rd District. Laura Richardson, 35th District. Stephen S. Choi, 37th District. Akilah Weber, 39th District.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. The next order of business is the oath of office for the senators-elect. Senators-elect and returning senators, if you could please proceed to the bar of the Senate to take your oath of office. All senators-elect, please advance to the bar of the Senate to take your oath of office. We have several special guests who are with us today. One of the busiest is the 40th governor of the state of California, who is going to be attending the proceeding in the assembly as well today. Can we please give a warm Senate welcome to the one, the only, Governor Gavin Newsom, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen of the Senate, the following senators have been selected to be an escort committee for the Chief Justice of the California Supreme Court, with Senators Umberg, Allen, Caballero, Durazo, Richardson, and Nilo proceed to the rear of the chamber. Proceed to the rear of the chamber in order to escort the Honorable Patricia Guerrero, Chief Justice of the California Supreme Court, who administer the oath of office. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for the Chief Justice of the California Supreme Court, Chief Justice Guerrero. The Chief Justice will be advancing the oath of office for Senator Cabaldon's desk. Madam Chief Justice, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much. For the office of member of the Senate, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
The duties upon which I'm about to enter.
The duties upon which I'm about to enter.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, loud and proud, can we please give a round of applause to the newly elected senators of the California State Senate. Everybody up on your feet and let me hear you. For the indulgence of each of you, we're going to take a group photo here of all the newly elected and sworn in senators. Senator Stern has his boo.
All right.
And the boo is back. California. You know, this is truly an emotional day. Many of the senators who are returning never had a formal swearing-in ceremony due to the pandemic, and we are so grateful to have been able to accomplish this here today. Ladies and gentlemen of the Senate, to all of our guests, if you're following along in your program today, the next order of business is Senate Resolution 1 by Majority Leader Gonzalez. Mr. Secretary, can you please read the resolution?
Senate Resolution 1 by Senator Gonzalez relative to holdover senators.
Senator Gonzalez, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. Senate Resolution 1 would have the holdover senators take their seats and have this House proceed to organize. I urge an aye vote.
Thank you so much, Senator Gonzalez. Is there any discussion or debate on this resolution? Senator Gonzalez is requesting an aye vote. Gonzalez is requesting an aye vote. We're going to take this via voice vote. All those in favor of the resolution, please state aye.
Aye.
All opposed? The ayes have it, and the resolution is adopted. All right. We're now going to make it official. The secretary is going to call the roll of all senators of the newly constituted California State Senate. Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Allen, Alvarado Gill, Archuleta, Areguin, Ashby, Becker, Blakespear, Cabaldon, Caballero, Cervantes, Choi, Cortese, Daly, Durazo, Gonzalez, Grayson, Grove, Hurtado, Jones, Laird, Limon, McGuire, McNerney, Menjivar, Nilo, Ochoa Bog, Padilla, Perez, Reyes, Richardson, Rubio, Sillarto, Smallwood Cuevas, Stern, Umberg, Valadares, Wahab, Weber, Wiener.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think that deserves a round of applause. The newly constituted California State Senate is official. We have a quorum. We're now going to be moving on to our next resolution. The next order of business is Senate Resolution Number 2 by the Majority Leader, Senator Gonzalez. Mr. Secretary, can you please read?
Senate Resolution 2 by Senator Gonzalez relative to the election of officers.
Senator Gonzalez, good afternoon. The floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. Senate Resolution 2 will elect Senator Mike McGuire as President pro tempore of the Senate, Erica Contreras as Secretary of the Senate, and Katrina Rodriguez as Sergeant at Arms of the Senate as our officers of the Senate for the 25-26 regular session. First and foremost, Secretary Contreras works tirelessly on behalf of the Senate and manages this body and our staff with grace, fairness, and integrity. She hails from Aguascalientes, Mexico, just like my family, and she works so hard on behalf of our Senate. She is the glue that holds us together. Katrina Rodriguez works diligently to keep us, our staff, and the public safe day in and day out, and her professionalism and kind demeanor are unmatched, and we thank her so much for her work. And last but not least, our president pro tempore, Mike McGuire, a force to be reckoned with, the son of Sonoma, the Energizer Bunny, and of course, an incredible friend to many of us, regardless of party affiliation. He has worked and will continue to work to oversee our important work in this chamber and will help lead our state to strengthen us as we move forward in these years ahead. We thank him for his service to California. And with that, I urge and I vote.
Thank you so much. I'm going to start getting emotional now. Madam Majority Leader, I'm nervous to ask this. Is there any debate or discussion on this resolution? Senator Gonzalez is requesting an aye vote. This will be a voice vote of the body. All those in favor of the resolution, please state aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Hot dang, there we go. The resolution passes, the ayes have it. Members of the State Senate, the oath of office will now be administered to the newly elected officers of the Senate by the Honorable Patricia Guerrero, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of California. We're going to request that Secretary Contreras and Chief Sergeant Rodriguez to please come to the bar of the Senate. I'm going to request Erica McGuire, my wife, to please advance to the rostrum, which I know she's very excited about. So, Erica, if you could please come forward. We're going to ask the Sergeant at Arms to please come forward. Quick run of show. We'll be officially sworn in. Then we're going to have the Chief Justice swear in the Secretary and the Chief Sergeant. Madam Chief Justice.
Congratulations. Please, for the office of President pro tempore of the Senate, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Mike McGuire.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend.
That I will support and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the Constitution of the United States.
To the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
And the Constitution of the State of California.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
And that I will well and faithfully discharge.
That I will well and faithfully discharge.
The duties upon which I am about to enter.
The duties upon which I'm about to enter.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you. We're now going to request that the Chief Justice heads to Senator Cabaldon's desk for the swearing in of Madam Secretary and Madam Sergeant at Arms. Madam Chief Justice, the floor is yours.
Erica Contreras-Vaez and Katrina Rodriguez, for the Office of Secretary of the Senate,
and Chief Sergeant at Arms, respectively, please raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear that you will support and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that you will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California, that you take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, and that you will well and faithfully discharge the duties upon which you are about to enter? If so, please affirm your oath by stating, I do.
I do.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we please give a round of applause to the Secretary of the Senate and the newly sworn in Sergeant of Arms, Katrina Rodriguez. I want to say it again, and I don't think I could say it enough. We are so incredibly grateful that each and every one of you are here today. To the family and friends who have traveled far and wide from every corner of this great state, we want to say welcome to your capital, the California State Capitol. And especially to the families of senators. The families of senators make enormous sacrifices to let those who serve in this august body do the job that they love. But I hope that you know the job is never more important than you are. And nothing can ever match the love we have for each of you. We are so grateful you are here. Can we please give a round of applause to the family and friends of the California State Senators? On behalf of this body, I'd like to take a moment to say a few thank yous. We need to take a moment to say thank you so much to the Chief Justice for attending our ceremony and swearing in senators. We want to be able to say thank you to Dr. Shirley Weber, Secretary of State. Can we please give her a round of applause and say thank you? I want to say thank you to Attorney General Bonta, Controller Malia Cohen, Fiona Ma, Treasurer, along with Board of Equalization Chair Sally Lieber for attending today. Can we please give them a round of applause? We are also honored by the presence of several retired senators who are here today, and we'd like to be able to acknowledge them and then also acknowledge retired President Pro Tems of the California State Senate. We'd like to be able to introduce, even though he needs no introduction, the one, the only, Mr. John Burton. We are also touched that President Pro Tem Steinberg is here. We also want to thank him for his amazing work as the mayor of Sacramento, just retired. Can we please give Pro Tem Steinberg a round of applause? To all of the county supervisors, mayors, and city council members, and tribal leaders who are here today, thank you for your partnership. To our friends in labor and the business community, together you keep the world's fifth largest economy humming, and we are grateful for you. And I think we also need to take a moment to congratulate all of the assembly members who are being sworn in today. You know, the assembly's success is our success, and we look forward to our work together in the months to come. The fact is this. The California State Senate, it is truly a special place. You know, in 175 years of statehood, only 1,199 Californians have served as senators. As Leader Jones stated last night, each senator is truly one in a million. And to all those returning senators and senators who are new to these chambers, I hope you just take a moment today. Look around these amazing surroundings. It is a surreal moment. And you all work so incredibly hard to get here. Senators knocked on thousands upon thousands of doors, hosted countless community meetings, phone call after phone call to voters, eating cold pizza almost every night at your headquarters. Let's be candid. It takes courage. It takes courage to put your name on the ballot and put yourself out there for criticism. But you are here now because you put in the work, you earned the community's trust, and the voters saw your passion. And today, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to get to work. Senators, are you ready to go? Let me hear you. Come on now. You know, this afternoon is a historic day in our state's capital. There are more members of color in the California State Senate than any other time in our state's history. We continue to see gains with LGBTQ membership. And for the first time ever, the Senate has reached a historic milestone with parity between women and men in the California State Senate. And I hope that you are with me. It is about damn time. Let me hear you, ladies and gentlemen. California leads the nation in many things. And these women leaders, Democrats and Republicans alike, they're leading the way to uplift the lives of millions in the Golden State. And today, and every day, we celebrate them, we celebrate their hard work, and we celebrate the diversity makes California strong and candidly separates this state from the rest of the pack. I hope that we can all agree, especially in this time in American history, let us never forget, California's diversity is our strength. It is who we are and who we've always been. And we will fight like hell to be able to protect everyone who calls California home in the years to come, including our immigrant communities, who are the backbone of our economy and an integral part of the fabric of our success. Are you ready to go, California? The Golden State is where the American nation meets the Pacific Ocean and the future. We feed the country and supply the world. We're the largest agricultural economy in America. We export almonds. We export the best wine in the world, oranges and strawberries. And yes, we export apple. California's entrepreneurial history is seen in the mines in Northern California, the movies filmed in Southern California, the microchips that are developed in the Silicon Valley, and the medical miracles that are being achieved right now in the great county of San Diego. California may beach, but let me be clear, we never coast. Californians are always learning. We are always leading, we are always discovering, and yes, California is always leading. Today, we have a special responsibility to help keep the California spirit thriving, to make California shine even brighter, and to deliver for all of the people of California. You know, we come together today, both in regular and in special session, to do the work for the people that we all work for. We put Californians first. And knowing this, and knowing what's ahead, this Senate must double down on our efforts to make life more affordable and livable, make our economy work for all and not just a privileged few. We need to lower energy costs, build more housing, continue to invest in our kids in strong public schools, modernize our electric grid, create family-sustaining good union jobs, and we need to get folks off our streets, get a roof over their head, and connect them to care. And I want to be... And let me say this. If Washington, D.C. refuses to tackle climate change in the coming 4 years, Mark my word, California will continue to lead as we always have. Because here in the Golden State, here in the Golden State, we fight to lift up every person, no matter your background, no matter your skin color, who you are, who you love, and how you identify. This is the California way. And let's be crystal clear. We will always stand strong for women and protect safe and unfettered access to reproductive health care and abortion care. Are you ready to go, California? Let me hear you. This is the moment. This is your moment. It is up to each one of us, all of us, Democrats and Republicans alike, to be able to feel the weight of this time and to be able to step up to meet it. You know, America's sun may set in California, but together, we're going to make sure that the future continues to rise here as well. I want to close with this. On the last night of last session, I talked about driving along the rural North Coast where I live, where my family is called home for four generations. And what I said is, when it looks like things may be getting dark, you turn the bright lights on. And that's what we all need to do here together. Turn the bright lights on. Work even harder, think even smarter, and do even better. Are we going to fight to protect the people, the policies, and the progress that make California great? Absolutely. We're going to go to the mat for them. But we also can't forget we have a lot to fix in this state as well. Fix the toughest challenges facing our communities with the innovative solutions that you are going to bring forward. I'm firm in the belief the highest calling in life is to help others, to fight for those who can't fight for themselves, and to work together no matter your party affiliation, because working together is the only way. It's the only way to make progress stick, and this is what we do in the state Senate. I look into this historic chamber, and I see 40 of the brightest lights, 40 of the brightest lights ever to come together under this Capitol dome. To our new colleagues, again, congratulations. To every member of the California State Senate, let's show the nation how leading can be done. Be proud of what you achieved. Dream big for how much more we can do. And let's shine the light of California. God bless the people of the Golden State. And here's to a great 2025. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. We are grateful that each of you are here. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen of the Senate, and to our guests, it is now my honor to introduce my friend, the Republican leader, Brian Jones.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, guests of the Senate. It's an honor to be with you this afternoon. Congratulations to Mike McGuire to your reelection as Senate pro tempore. We are excited about your leadership and continued dialogue and cooperation across the aisle. Congratulations to Erica Contreras and Katrina Rodriguez for their reelection to their leadership posts. We know that they are actually the backbone of what makes this building work and keeps us on time, keeps the trains running on time, and keeps us all getting here on time and out of here on time. So thank you very much. Congratulations. It's been said sometimes that serving in the legislature is similar to buying a boat. The two best days are the day you take the oath, and the next best day is the last day of session. And so as we look forward to sometime in September of the last day of session this year, I know that we are going to have many times together where we are going to be working together and cooperating and agreeing on the things that we need to do for all of our constituents, for 39 million Californians, to fix California. But there's also going to be times when there's heated debate. And not always are those debates across party lines. Sometimes those debates are within party lines. And I think what's important to remember at the end of the day, no matter how emotional, no matter how passionate, no matter how exasperated we might become in our service here in the Senate, that we leave each day knowing that the other person also has the best interests of California in mind. I'm going to pare down my comments. I had about 2 hours of comments, but since the pro tem didn't take his whole 2 hours, I won't take my whole 2 hours. One thing I do want to share with all of us, and I share this with my Republican constituents and my Democratic constituents. Let's not get too nervous. Let's not get too excited. Let's not get too upset about what's happening in Washington, D.C. What has happened in California over the last 8 years has been an example to the rest of the country on how people can work together across party lines to get good things done. Well, I believe we also set the example for courageous but polite debate. When we disagree, we bring our passions, we bring our arguments, we bring those things that are important to us and our constituents to the table, but we also recognize that they're just policies. They're just things to debate, but we all remain friends and continue working together. One of the things I like to tell my constituents when they come up to me and they're very animated or upset or serious about something they've seen on national television, especially the cable networks. And they're, you know, you can see them, they're red in the face. Their hair might be on fire a little bit. Whether it's Fox News or MSNBC or CNN or any of the others, I tell my constituents, take a break. Turn the TV off for a couple of days. The world's not going to end while you take a break from the national chaos and national scene. Let's concentrate on California. Let's focus on how great it is to live here in California. Let's focus, as the pro tem said, on all of the great attributes, the beaches, the mountains, the deserts, and everywhere else in between, on how great of a state California is. Many of us were not born here in California. Many of us came here from other countries or other states. My family moved here in 1978. My dad was a home builder in Colorado. We came to San Diego on vacation on a whim. And in the 2 weeks we were in San Diego, we fell in love with California. I was 10 years old when that happened. We moved home. I didn't quite understand everything that was happening. My dad sold his business, sold the houses that we lived in, the houses that he was building, sold his truck, 1968 Chevy truck with a Corvette engine, sold that, packed up the kids and the dog, and we moved to California. And California is the golden state. California was the state of opportunity then. California remains the state of opportunity. You have my commitment as the Republican leader that we are going to work together across the aisle and cooperation on the things that we can agree on to make sure that we're all moving the ball forward and that we're doing the very, very, very best job that we can for all of our constituents and continue to work on fixing California. Thank you very much.
Leader Jones, thank you for those eloquent words and grateful to work with you and your caucus each and every day. To recognize this momentous occasion, reaching parity here in the California State Senate, I'd like to be able to turn the floor over to Senator Lamone, also Vice Chair of the Women's Caucus, under privileges of the floor. Senator Lamone, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, colleagues and guests. I rise on behalf of the Legislative Women's Caucus on this historic moment for the Senate in the state of California. Today, women account for more than 50% of our senators, marking the first time in history that this great state has reached gender parity in either house of our legislature. The women in this caucus represent all parts of the state: Central Valley, Northern California, Southern California, Inland Empire, Central Coast, and the North Coast. We lead policy conversation in all areas, including agriculture, labor, business, profession, finance, public safety, health, and so much more. We are daughters, we're mothers, we're labor leaders, we're small business owners. We are California. The Legislative Women's Caucus was founded in 1985, and we have come a long way since its founding, but have come an even longer way since the founding of this state in 1850. In the last 174 years, we have accomplished much. And today, we make history. Our strength is not just in numbers, but it is in the diverse representation that we bring in a bipartisan way to this legislature. Members of the Legislative Women's Caucus, I'd like to invite you to please stand. Members, this is our Legislative Women's Caucus. This is California, and family and guests and colleagues, this is history. Congratulations.
Thank you, Senator Limon. Go us. As we're moving on with the order, the next order of business is Senate Resolution 3 by Senator McGuire.